Rochester. And yeah, and it's really rare. Big shout out to all of you guys. We're really happy to have you here. Now, before I keep rambling, I'm going to introduce the master of ceremony. This is Pradeva Jogasukumar. Pradeva Aunty has known Shreya since she was born, and she's an active member of the Indian community in Buffalo. She has a PhD from UB and is a member of the chemistry faculty at Erie Community College. She is an avid consumer of classical Indian music and dance. And today, she will be the one who's the real host and will be navigating you through our Shreya's program. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming Pradeva Aunty.
Is a mead, or it's a sort of a dragging of notes. The rock brings up romantic ethos. There are several songs in Hindi, Rabindra Sangeet, and Marathi based on the rock. Shreya will bring the drut. Shreya will sing the drut or fast tempo. Drut is similar to allegro in Western classical music. Bandish, that is the bound or a structured form, is a musical composition in a rag set to a thal. The bandish should represent the grammar and format of a rag in its purity. The bandish for this rag is Jagu Me Sari Rehna Balma in Teen Thal, that is a 16-beat cycle. Shreya, take the floor.
Ah. Yeah.
words before we move on. Hindustani music is songs and renditions in various modes, songs for times of the day and seasons of the year. Priya is going to sing the next two pieces in Thumri and folk style. Thumri is a form of light classical vocal music, mainly characterized by the freedom it takes from the taal and raag roots, and depicts various moods associated with sentimental love. These are compositions composed and sung by Srimati Girija Devi. It is befitting to say a few words about Srimati Girija Devi. Vidushi Girija Devi is a renowned icon and the greatest living singers of Thumri and Dadra. She sings in the style of Banaras Gharana and performs the Purvi, that is the Eastern Ang or style of Thumri. Girija Devi is the reigning queen of Thumri Dadra singing. Her repertoire includes the semi-classical genres Jhula, Kajri, Chaiti, Khayal, Holi and Tappa. Her quest and primary focus has been on the rasa, that is, the expression of emotion to convey various forms of love, such as love of God, love for the beloved, etc. And to this extent, she has changed the entire complexion of Thumri. In many of her compositions, she combines semi-classical style with regional characteristics of Bihar and Eastern UP, that is Purvan. Mrs. Girija Devi was on the faculty of IPC Sangeet Research Academy of Kolkata and Banaras Hindu University. She is the recipient of many awards, including Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, Sangeet Natak Academy Award, and the esteemed Padma Vibhushan. With great pride and pleasure, I would like to inform our audience that our own Mrs. Mamata Bhargava, Mamata Ji, as she is affectionately called, is the disciple of Girija Devi. Mamata Ji addresses her guru affectionately as Appa. And we are proud to have Mamata Ji amongst us here. And teaching so many students. Next up is a jhula composed by Appa. Jhula is a semi-classical song sung in rainy season while playing on swings. The jhula is in the Avadhi dialect. The taal is... One second. The taal is Kehrwa. Iske bol hain. Siya sang jhule bagiya mein Ram lalna. This says that Siya is swinging in the jhula with Ram, and Lakshman is pushing the swing. I believe this is a favorite at the Kanak Bhavan temple in Ayodhya. Sure.
Thank you.
Hindu calendar. Chaiti is a genre of semi-classical vocal music in Tumri style again, based on folk songs sung to welcome spring in UP and adjoining areas, and is sung after the festival of Holi. Invariably, a Chaiti marks Rama at the beginning of the line and Ho Rama at the end. Shreya will sing the Chaiti, Chaitra Maas to Chunuri, Rangayo Lo Ho Rama, Piya Ghar Aaye Hain. The bhav of the Chaiti is about thoughts of a wife, how she will dress herself in colorful clothes to receive her husband, and how she will adorn herself in the jewelry to entice him.
Ah.
I was transported to a village where somebody was singing and we are all enjoying that singing. That's how the mood was created by Shri. Next rag is Rag Bharti. This rag is an order Sampoon rag, implying that it has five notes in the Arohan, that is why going up the scale, and uses seven notes in the Avrohan, that is coming down in scale. It belongs to Kalki Thaat and is sung in the third prahar, Tisra prahar, or third part of the day, which is late afternoon, early evening, which is about now. It uses Komal Gandhar, Shuddh Ni, instead of Komal Ni. Its prakriti is chanchal and reflects a mood of anguish or longing. This rag is similar to Ragni Palasi, and there are several movie songs based on this rag. For those of you who like to listen to Indian movie songs, classical music related songs, the song Megha Chai Aarti Rag is, I think it's from movie Shabili, is based on Rag Bharti. This is the designated time to sing this rag, and Shreya will be singing the Dhrut Khayal with the Bandish Maitore Sandhna Jam in Taal Teen Thaal, 16 minutes.
Thank you.
getting settled, I will talk a little bit about these dohas. Next, we have Kabir Das ke dohe. Kabir Das was born in the 14th century. He was a weaver or julaha by profession, and he ranks among the world's greatest poets. Guru Granth Sahib or Adi Granth or the holy book of the Sikhs contains 500 verses by Kabir. Kabir's poetry is very simple but has deep philosophy. The hallmark of Kabir's poetry is that he conveys the philosophy of mysticism and his ardor for the supreme in two liners called dohe. I'm sure that most of us studied Kabir ke dohe and their vyakhyan or detailed meaning in middle and high school, especially in the north. They'll be singing, Shreya will be singing several dohas with her brother Karn. Incidentally, Karn sang these dohas on his vocal recital as well, which was, I'm assuming, about 5 to 6 years back. Karn graduated from Carnegie Mellon with a degree in economics and statistics and is continuing with his master's in industrial and system engineering. Karn plays the guitar and has kept up with his singing and was part of a cappella. I just want to mention a couple of dohas. One which they'll be singing is Mati Kahe Kumhar Se, Tu Kya Rondhe Mohe, Ek Din Aisa Aayega, Main Rondhungi Toh. The meaning is, the clay is saying to the potter that today he is molding the clay, but a day will come when the potter will be reduced to ashes and clay will then mold him. The philosophical thought is that after death, we all become formless and one with earth. If I can take your permission, I want to say another one. Chalti chakki dekh kar diya kabe kabira roye, dui patan ke beech mein sabit bachana koye. This refers to Prithvi and Akash, that is earth and sky, and that within these, the whole creation exists. And we are trapped between dualities, day and night, life and death, joys and sorrows, and our life is a perpetual motion like the chakki. Chakki is that grinding stones. And trapped in this duality, everything is perishable like the dhane, yam ke dhane, and nothing is eternal. So they'll be singing, I think, 6 dohas. So Shreya and Karn, enjoy your singing.
Thank you.
Thank you. season of the year. Western composers evoke nature's fury with orchestral music that imitates sounds of weather, like some of you must have heard Vivaldi. Indian composers depict monsoon rains in abstract terms with the classical raga system. Monsoon, being a unique phenomenon in India, has an important place in our music and is supposed to be a creation of Niya Tansen and patronized by Emperor Akbar. Rag Malhar is associated with the atmosphere of torrential rains. The combinations of the melody can really ape the vagaries of nature with the thunder of clouds and the rain torrents falling from the sky onto the earth. This rag belongs to Thar Kafi and has a Sampoorn Jati, that is, it is using all the seven swaras. Samvadi Swar is the second most important note of the rag and is Sa. Shreya is going to sing the bandesh Bole De Papedhara in Rag Niya Malhar and Badarwa Barsan Ko Aaye in the variation in Rag Sur Malhar. The beat is Tinta.
Thank you.
another folk song called Kajri. Kajri, the word is derived from Hindi word kajra, kajal, or kol, meaning black. It is a genre of Hindustani semi-classical music popular in Eastern UP and Bihar. It describes the rainy season and the black monsoon clouds after a hot summer and the joy that the rain brings. Kajri has associated themes of separation, longing and reunion with the beloved. It is one of the most popular and well-known forms of folk music. Shreya is singing the Kajri. Ghir aaye hai kaji badaliya, Radhe bin lage na mora jiya, in raag mishru pilu and said to Kal Bhairava. Now the meaning of these words is, in these words Shyam, that is Krishna, is expressing his feelings of longing for Radha and that he has looked for Radha everywhere. Girija Devi composed the lyrics to honor Radha and give her importance, as Krishna is always the Nayak of the song and gets all appreciation. But Radha does not get her fair due. Krishna tries to woo Radha in different ways. In the end, Krishna uses his veto power and says, Jab lo Radhe maan na todi hai, bansi dhariyam na kabho adharva. Meaning, till Radha will not break her ego, he will not touch the flute of his lips.
Thank you. Pura Guru. Bye.
बहुत खूब शेर. Before I introduce you to the last piece, I would like to congratulate Sumita and Kaushlesh for providing Shreya with encouragement, support, love, and of course hours of driving to take her to Mamtaji to get to this pinnacle of classical music. Bhajan is a song, a poem, characterized by words of worship and piety. Meera, as you know, was a mystic saint, a saint of the Bhakti movement of 16th century. The bhajan expresses Meera's divine eternal love for Lord Krishna. Some of her poetry is included in Prem Abodh Ambod Poetry by Guru Gobind Singh Ji, which includes poetry of 16 historic saints important to Sikhism, and Kabir Das was one of those. Now here is Shreya singing Maharo Pranam Banke Bihari Ji, set to Rag Yaman Kalyan and Tal Bhajani in her melodious voice. Banke Bihari Ji refers to Krishna. I just want to say that Shreya, your singing was from the heart and your voice is so sweet and melodious. I guess Shreya sings not because she's happy that she sings so beautifully. And just a last bit of note, when you leave the hall, please take your program sheets and the water bottles and do not leave anything in the hall. Thank you.
Thank you. Just want to acknowledge Vishnu Anka. He's accompanied a generation of artists in Buffalo and in Rochester. And Anka, it's always amazing to hear you play. Thank you very much. He was a professor at University of Rochester in physics, and he's a musician, so he's multi-talented. We're very lucky to have him in this community, and hopefully we'll hear him all for very much, much, many, many more years. Amelia and Sophia, beautiful artists, you did an amazing job today. Thank you so much, and we're looking forward to hearing your solo performances in the near future. I mean, very soon. We spent countless hours practicing this fair in Buffalo, and we really appreciate the time and the effort they put into this. And I'd like to thank Pradeepa, who's Professor Pradeepa, and she took you through the ceremony and the different pieces today. And the interesting thing is that if you go online and take a short test, you get continuing education credits for appreciation of Hindi music, and you get a full certificate. So, Pradeepa, thank you very much. We'll go quickly now. it took a lot of people to execute this. For the decoration, we had a decorations committee. We had Savita move his flight to the right, Mehta. Sangeeta move his flight to the left, Armin. The decorations. Radhika, if it moves a few inches front, it will be perfect. Ramesh, Anupma needs more color. Mahotra, and Supriya, let's just start over sing. On video taking is my friend Dr. Nilesh Patel. I'm sorry, Dr. I could have been a director Patel. On the photos, it's Abbas. Is that really your best side, Kumar? For the food setup, we have my sister Karen and her lovely husband Matt. You'll see them when you walk over. And Vivek has been helping out in just about everything. As well as my two nephews and my niece, they got very good at lifting things and putting them down and following directions. Dinners will be served by a 40 Love tennis club, my Madhu Shastri, the president of that. So a couple of things about it. We're going to have two lines so everything can get everybody to go through quickly. To get there, you put signs out and all. It's in building 3, which is just down that way. So if you go out, make a right, make a quick left, and there's a stairway going up. And just follow the stairway to the next building and you'll see it. If you can't walk up the stairway and you need an elevator, just behind the stairway there's an elevator, you can do that instead. So let's go. I won't be there, I have to finish cleaning up. But if you guys head over there, we'll meet you there shortly. Sunita will. Last time, I forgot to thank Sunita, of course. through the whole process, we've been preparing this for several months now, and through this whole process, it's been amazing. She never raised her voice, she never shouted anything. Completely calm, nothing ever fazed her. It was, it was an amazing job. Without her, we'd probably be at home singing, "Row, row, row your boat." And to the audience, heartfelt. Being part of Rochester and the Buffalo music community, none of this would be memorable, none of this would mean anything without you guys being able to share this moment with us. So thank you very much.